Well, Brannigan and Flanagan were talking at the cross, when up comes Larry Lanigan, a driving of an ass. Says he, poor Peter Finnegan, is laid out mighty flat, while readying his supper he was bitten by the cat. Says Brannigan to Flanagan and Flanagan to Lanigan, little Peter Finnegan will not get over that. But little Peter Finnegan is running out and in again, for that one taste of Finnegan had paralysed the cat. Well, when Peter grew up big and brown, a blacksmith he was made, and not a man in all the town could bait him at his trade. One day to chase some corner boys, he rushed out of his shed. A motor car was passing, and it struck him on the head. Says Brannigan to Flanagan, Flanagan to Lanigan, I hear poor Peter Finnegan has gone to glory clean. But Brawny Peter Finnegan's a hardy man to run again. They found that Peter Finnegan was mending the machine. Well, the boys in all the barony were courting Mary Flynn, and not a man but Finnegan would have a chance to win. The others, when they'd meet her about the dowry, would begin. But I'll take you girls, says Peter, in the clothes you're standing in. Say, Brannigan to Flanagan, Flanagan to Lanigan, it isn't Peter Finnegan she'll honour and obey. But not a man but Finnegan will flirt with Mary Flanagan, for bruising Peter Finnegan she married yesterday. Now, 'twas politics that Finnegan would study day and night. He'd argue wrong was mostly right, and black was really white. And when the next election came, the posters on the wall said, vote for Peter Finnegan, and the divil attacks at all. Says Brannigan to Flanagan, Flanagan to Lanigan, the vote that Peter gives himself, his only vote will be. But Finnegan can win again, no matter who he's in again, and bruising Peter Finnegan is Finnegan T.D.